When we're selling. So put your arms across your chest and say, I love selling. Now, who was telling the truth when they said that? Who was lying when they said that? And who wasn't game to be honest at all or tell me at all? Well, do you think it's important to be enthusiastic when you're selling? I mean, you're in a clothes shop and the assistant says, oh, you don't look too bad in that. I mean, are you going to buy that? No way. But if they go, wow, you look fantastic in that. Sold. Of course you're going to buy it if someone's enthusiastic. So that's the way we need to start our day. And you talked a lot about mindset today. So today we're going to talk about three techniques that you can use to get business fast and double your sales in 30 days. And we're going to I'm going to talk to you about how to use phone and email in conjunction with online marketing. And then at the end today, I'm going to give you two daily habits that have been really good for me that have kept me in business for 35 years. Raise your hand if that sounds good. Okay. Now, another way you can get more sales is, of course, by prospecting and cold calling. But I don't call it cold calling, it's warm calling. Because nowadays you have no excuse not to find out about someone before you call. There are plenty of ways. So prospecting is like mining for gold. You've got to dig through a lot of dirt before you get to someone who says yes. So you might have to make 20 calls, 50 calls. Think about it. Just write down on the sheet in front of you, what is one customer worth to you a year? Now, if you add on the referrals business and you add on what that any other business, any upsells you do to that client, what is one customer worth to you? Has someone got something with a high figure? Give me an example. What's one customer worth to you? You don't have any customers? 30 grand here? What, Claire?
Yeah, the lifetime value could easily be 100 grand.
Exactly. So how many calls do you actually have to do? When you think about it, you think, oh, prospecting, I couldn't do that. But you could, because if you work out how many clients you really need a year, based on how much you want to make. So if you have a $100,000 client, you probably only need three clients. So would you make 50 calls to get one more client? It'd be worth it, yeah. So if you think about it that way, it's a really good way to think about it. But of course, this thing called call reluctance happens. And we don't, when you've had a lot of that mindset, so you use all those tools you've got from today to get that mindset correct. But really, what, you know, call reluctance is due to fear of rejection. You know where that comes from? They did a survey with children of the age of two, and they had 400 no's said to them a day and four yeses. So it's like, that's really, really, it's true. We feel a feeling of rejection, and we carry that into our adulthood too. So we don't like people saying no to us. But no is an opportunity for you to do the call better next time. That's simply all it is. And they never take rejection personally. So fear of rejection, no goals, but of course it's your beliefs, attitude, and self-talk. So be careful with your self-talk. Everybody stand up for a minute. This is how powerful your mind is. Put your fingers up in the air and really focus on your two fingers and say, fingers come together, fingers come together, fingers come together, fingers come together. Okay, anybody's fingers not come together? put your hand up. Because you were probably thinking negative self-talk. This won't work for me. It'll work for everybody else. Okay, fingers up in the air. Look, focus on your fingers. Fingers stay apart. Fingers stay apart. Fingers stay apart. Well done, you're focused. The power of our mind is absolutely crazy, isn't it? So anyway, this is a little mantra you can say to yourself every day, because you don't want to do that, right? You'd rather do the filing than do the calls, but what's going to get you the business, the filing or the calls? So you say, I am a, and three really good qualities about yourself. So it could be confident, empathetic, enthusiastic salesperson who loves to help people invest in my services. Today, I plan to make X number of calls and make X number of sales or appointments. Would that be a better way to start the day rather than thinking, oh, I've got to do those cold calls? One thing that's just my thing, but it could help you too, is make a difference to someone's day, every day. So I either give people a referral, an idea how to do something, I say a thank you, because not many people say thank you these days. And I know how good that feels for me, and so I do it to other people. Now, a lot of people have helped me in business, and I ring them and say thank you. So just when I think of them. And there was one guy who used to send me positive quotes on a regular basis. And I was like, I love them. And so, you know, when I said thank you to him, he was over the moon. He just said, not many people do that. So do it. Just to sum up my talk, the three main things you've got to remember are to follow up relentlessly, ask more questions, and make 10 prospecting calls per day. But nothing's going to happen unless you internalize this in the body. So I like to start off with the music we had. So we're going to do, everybody stand. We're going to just get you fit for sales, because when you're laughing and having fun, you're fit for sales. So we do the little walk to the music. You can put it on, okay? So we're going to follow up. Four follow-ups. We're going to move those hips with a question mark. Make a question mark. And then we're going to go 10 calls a day. 10 calls a day. All right, one more time. Follow up, follow up, follow up. Question mark. How many calls a day? 10. Keep dancing, keep having fun, and happy selling. Thank you.